The facts about Vex. Fact. Vaccinations cause autism, paralysis, and even death. Fact. Vaccinate rhymes with masturbate. Would you let a doctor do that to your kid? Fact. I still think Michelle Williams is Carrie Mulligan. Fact.
Medical delivery for badass karate doctor.
Ah, yes, those must be the bones and skulls. I see no boob bones. The victim was a man.
Wow.
Oh, yeah!
Say no to vaccines. Paid for with Meg's College Fund.
What the hell is all this?
I'm trying to protect myself from all those diseases I'm not vaccinated against. Speaking of which, do you have any idea the germs you routinely track into this house? From now on, I'm going to ask that you wear these shoes while indoors.
Where'd you get those?
Put them on and lick your lips.
Stewie, you might be taking this too far.
Proper hygiene depends on everyone, Brian. For instance, I've already saran-wrapped Chris.
I'm a gas station sandwich.
We interrupt this program with breaking news. Childhood vaccination rates in Quahog have dropped to an all-time low, fueled by a recent media campaign led by local meddler Peter Griffin, shown here in the basket of Henry Thomas's bicycle. That can't be real, right?
Oh, I knew one of these had to be my house.
Damn it, Peter, thanks to you, nobody in this town is vaccinating their kids anymore. Do you even realize the harm you've caused?
Harm? What are you talking about? I'm making the world a better place. Like when I was the Instagram police. Sorry, lady, gotta crop the church. I will take this. And cut away complete. Man, there is a lot of bad art in these hallways.
All right, Stewie, see you after school. Wait a minute, where are all the other kids?
Haven't you heard? There's been an outbreak of measles. It's all because everyone stopped vaccinating their kids.
Oh, my God.
And it's not just our school. Kids all over town are getting sick.
Attention! Attention!
What the hell?
People of Quahog, your town is under quarantine. Until further notice, no one may enter or leave the city.
Oh, that's the guy who bought the bullhorn at the park.
Oh, this is awful. It's all our fault.
And look, Joe's arguing with a state policeman over jurisdiction.
Thanks, Swanson. We'll take it from here. It's a state matter now.
No way. This is my town.
Thanks, guys. The feds will take it from here.
Oh, no. This is my state.
Hi, I'm a crossing guard who can walk, so I have jurisdiction over all of you.
Must be serious. They brought in the big guns.
You happy now, Lois? Because of you, there's a measles epidemic and the whole town is quarantined.
Speak for yourself, Brian. I, for one, am enjoying the indoor family time. Who's up for another game of hot breath telephone?
We're all gonna die!
Chris, you're supposed to whisper that to the next person.
Peter, Brian's right. We were wrong about everything. We've gotta get to the hospital and get Stewie vaccinated.
Yeah, it might be a little too late for that. I kinda destroyed all the vaccines in town. What else did I have to do today? Ah, yes, overdose in my apartment. I better get home.
You destroyed all the vaccines?
Yeah, but it's fine. There's nothing to worry about. Is anyone else feeling feverish, achy, and acutely sensitive to light?
Oh, my God, Peter. You've got measles.
Now, hold on. Hold on. Before we all freak out, it might just be full-body herpes.
Wait, you guys, Dad might not have been vaccinated. Didn't Grandma say he was born in Mexico?
Nobody remembers that, Meg.
We gotta keep you away from Stewie. You'll get him sick.
Oh, my little guy's gonna be fine. All he needs is a good old-fashioned game of hot breath telephone.
Measles. Ah! I've gotta get out of this house or I'll be in worse shape than John Goodman.
I've got your EKG here.
How does it look?
Well, it spells out pancakes.
Oh, okay, so same as last time.
I'm recommending you go on a strict diet immediately.
Nope. Horses that make it look like I can walk, take me to Hollywood.